name is Shay. Welcome to my channel, Manifesting with Karmic Psych-Gal. Here I discuss manifesting the life you deserve to have, my process through ascension, and of course, spirituality in general. If you're new to my channel, thanks for tuning in. If you like this video, go ahead and like it and subscribe to my channel. Hit that notification bell so you can be alerted when I post. And if you're part of the spiritual family, welcome back. I'm so glad to be with you guys in this space of healing and unconditional love. I'm in a new space a little bit, so like bear with me that I'm getting used to this camera angle and all that jazz. I hope you guys like it and enjoy it. If you can see from the title of this video, I'm going to be talking about the full moon eclipse in Taurus, which has occurred today. Now, although this alignment passed through at 3:45 a.m., it is going to continue to affect us with this next coming week. So I just want to discuss a little bit the energies around it and how it is that you can take the most advantage of that energy and use it for manifestation purposes, of course. Now, it is a full moon. So like I usually say, on full moons is a time for releasing. It is a time for processing your emotions, your feelings, letting go of the things that are not serving you, really just reassessing your month that you had and if your actions were in alignment with your goals. And because this is an eclipse, this specifically highlights where we want to be looking at into our shadow side and the things that trigger us and how it is that we are tending to those things and really caring for ourselves. This full moon eclipse is in the sign of Taurus. If you know anything about Taurus, they're really mellow people, really calm, chill. They're known for loving comfort, being indulgent in luxury and beautiful experiences. They love to eat. Taurus also can be really stubborn. Taurians can be very stubborn and they have a hard time really being flexible. They are super hard workers and have to be mindful about how much work and energy they are putting out towards the world. So these are all things that we're going to be focused on during this full moon eclipse. During this time, you really want to take a moment, maybe journal, meditate, whatever it is that you usually do, what's in your full moon routine. These are going to be the things that support you in releasing and expressing your emotions and your thoughts, okay? And you want to make sure that you are communicating effectively during this time and speaking from your heart space. During this time, you really want to look at the things that are blockages in your life regarding your self-care regimen and the things that you do that are anti-self-care. A lot of times we look at self-care and we think about getting a facial, you know, going to get a pedicure, things that are really just aesthetically pleasing and make us feel good on the outside. But the real self-care is how it is that you are treating your inner side and your spirit, okay? And a lot of this looks like negative self-talk, fears, doubts, you know, anxiety about the future, self-sabotage. Even your daily routine can play into a huge part of you being anti-self-care. And when I say daily routine, I mean the little things that you do every day ultimately lead up to the person you are and the life that you are creating. So me, if I want to be an influencer, if I want to be a YouTuber, then I have to act like a YouTuber. That means that I should be posting just as much as an influencer as a YouTube. I should be tagging people in my pictures just like an influencer or a YouTuber would. And you just have to figure out how does that apply to you in your life. What is it that you could be doing right now that is going to put you into alignment with your goals and the dreams that you have for your life? And everybody says, well, what is shadow work? When, how do you know when you're supposed to do it? How am I supposed to cut out time for this? I already don't have time. Well, the thing is that shadow work actually finds you. You actually don't have to do anything at all. All you have to do is go about living your merry life. And I promise you, there's going to be things that occur throughout your day, throughout your week, throughout your month that trigger you. And triggers are things that cause you to have an emotional response that is unwarranted, okay? So when you are reacting to something based off of a past experience, then you are being triggered. So you want to pay attention to what's going on in your daily life, things that people say to you, things that you do, things that are coming up repetitively in your life that says, you know, this really isn't the best for me, so I probably need to stop doing that. And that is going to be shadow work. You know, some things that I had to do shadow work was detachment. I had a really unhealthy relationship with attachment and codependency. I really had to work through that because of issues that I suffered as a child. Other things that I had to work through is just feeling like I'm enough and knowing that I have value and self-worth. And I had to figure out what that meant to me and how can I show up better in my life, support myself through the times where I don't feel valuable. What can I do right now to feel more value? What makes me feel valued? So when you get these opportunities, when you have these triggers, this is a moment for you to reflect and ask yourself what questions. It's very specific that you only ask questions that begin with what, because what leads you to take action. So what can I do differently? What can I do with the tools that I have right now? What would make me happy right now? What do I want? What do I like to do? What am I passionate about? What does my future look like to me? What is my ideal partner like? Things like this is going to have you take action. It's going to provoke a thought and a response. So you're going to be actually visualizing as you are meditating on what it is that you want and what it is that you need. And you may realize shortly that a lot of those things you're capable of giving to yourself and you just didn't know how. And when you come to terms with that and accept that you just didn't have the tools at the time, you make peace and you accept that although those experiences sucked, they were meant to bring you to this space that you are in now. And that's a really beautiful and peaceful place to be at. Taurus is a sign that's all about comfort. So during this time of transformation, it is calling you to step out of your comfort zone. There is going to be a separation of people, and there always is. There's two types of people. There are the people who come, we all are at this impasse in our life, and it's like, I'm not happy. I don't like what I'm doing. Okay, I'm going to step out of line and do something that I really care about and is really passionate about, and I can make an impact in the world. And when you get to that place, you'll realize you get to a point of, I'm not where I want to be yet, but I can't go back to where I am. And there's two people. There's one person that's going to keep going and keep pushing to get to that new, better version of themselves and keep being consistent and doing the thing that's in alignment with what they want. And then there's the person that is going to be too uncomfortable to keep going. And they're going to go back in that place where they felt comfortable at, where they felt like it was easier. And sometimes it is easier, but in the long run, it will always pay off to do something that you're afraid of or try something risky. The definition of insanity is doing the same thing the same way multiple times and expecting different results. So what results are you trying to get and what are you going to do to make those results happen? This moon cycle is all about your identity and who you choose to be. We all have choices. I'm going to link an episode below to my friend's podcast, Mindful BS. And last week they had an episode where they talked about choices and just the choices that we choose to make in every day. And we can make so many excuses to say, oh, I couldn't do this, I couldn't do that. But at the end of the day, we all have choices. And the little tiny choices that we make every day make up our future and what it is that we decide for it to be. So every day that you put off doing the things that you want to do, trying something new, doing something outside of your comfort zone, it's just another day that you're going to be staying exactly where you are. This week's affirmation is, I allow myself to breathe and release anything that weighs heavy on my spirit. So during this time of releasing and letting go of the things that don't serve us, and a lot of it really being in our control that we can change, with this Taurus energy, it is really causing us to reflect and look at us and how we're feeling. When we're doing shadow work, the way that you know you are healing and that you are moving in the right direction is if that you are moving towards the direction of love, okay? The universal white light is an energy of unconditional love and healing vibrations. So when you start to find peace and acceptance with the things that happen to you, the experiences that you have and continue to have, you're healing and you're doing the shadow work. You're doing exactly what you need to do. The things that you still feel burdened by, still get irritated at, or, you know, still blame yourself for, or even hold other people hostage for, are all things that you need to have shadow work on, because the master statement is detachment, honestly, and that is nothing belongs to me. When you realize that nothing belongs to you, you'll never feel like you're losing anything or anybody. And there comes a huge wave of peace just by accepting that. And it's really important. It's like the serenity prayer, and it says, God, please grant me. So the serenity prayer goes, God, grant me the serenity to accept the things that I cannot change. Change the things that I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. And when you find that wisdom, you will be at great peace. Earlier this week, I posted the Life Path 22 video, and it was so interesting that I'm still in the energy and vibration of 22. And then we hit the full moon eclipse in Taurus, okay? Because 22, the number itself, is a number of universal love. And during this time, the universe is asking us to seek balance in all things, in our mind, body, and spirit, on our practices, in our work-life balance. And this is all things that surrounded in that Taurian energy. So you really want to take a look at the things that are holding you back, the things that you keep you stagnant. And a lot of them is the mind. Your mind is the magic key. Your mind has all the power. And the thing is that you have all the power, because you can choose to change your mind at any time. So whatever you say is what it is. Whatever you speak into existence, whatever you perceive things are, that is what's generally true. So when you speak things into existence, like all of your dreams finally coming true, having peace, being fulfilled in life, you're going to start having those things happen to you. And when it does, just come back and shout your girl out. This energy is really calling us to take a look at our relationships and finding the balance in them, understanding that you don't have any control over other people. You only have control over yourself, and accepting, understanding people and their differences, and also understanding that a lot of the times, any problems that you have in relationships is usually not about you. Just think about whenever you're having going through a hard time, whether it's related to mental health or, you know, just general stress about money, whatever it is that you possibly could be going through, that affects you on every level, mind, body, and spirit. And when something affects you on every level, it affects you physically on the outside. That's how you treat people differently, how you're treating yourself. So when you realize that, you come into this space of acceptance that, oh, when that person treated me bad, that was just a reflection of how they feel about themselves. And I forgive and I release that, because I also needed that experience, because I didn't understand my value and worth at the time either. And relationships are literally mirrors. The universe sends you every person that you come into contact with. It's a mirror. Every person is a reflection of your energy. And the things that we see in other people that we don't like is usually things that we see in ourselves and wish that we could change. You know what I mean? And things that we also see in people that we don't like, that we might be jealous or intimidated of, are qualities that we wish we had. Our relationships are meant to teach us and mirror us. And it's just really important that you're listening to your triggers, your emotions, and how it is that you feel when you get in certain environments and around certain people. Know the discernment of what is for you and what is not for you, okay? And just really during this time, give your relationship space to grow. Give the people space to grow and catch up to where you are. And if maybe you're the one who needs to do some growing, don't be hard on yourself. Give yourself that self-care and that love that you need. And the other people, it will be more people. If you lost somebody because you weren't ready yet, there'll be more people, okay? If somebody treated you bad and you thought you would be there for a long time, there will be more people. The universe is always going to send you what you need when you need it. You just have to stay optimistic and continue to do the things that are in alignment with your purpose and who it is that you want to be, ultimately. I know this video was a little bit all over the place, but I really hope that you enjoyed it and you got something out of it, whether it was for this full moon or later on in life. I'm sure that whenever you see this message, it's right when you need it. Go ahead and subscribe to my channel, like this video if you did enjoy it. And if you want to book a personal reading with me, whether it is based off of numerology, astrology, a birth chart, find more about your life purpose, you can book a life path reading with me. The link is going to be in the description box. You guys can go ahead and book with me. And I'll see you in my next video. Peace.